Hi everyone, it's the English Simmer here and welcome back to my short Lifespan Legacy Challenge. And can I just say, these toddlers, they've already got the picture. They already know the family legacy, they know the weight that their name carries, and they just said, here you go, I'm gonna serve myself on a silver platter to be your next heir. And that is because I was just playing through getting ready for, obviously, Aiden's little graduation, which, by the way, I do realize that I was a complete noob and I actually just missed, like, where the private attorney was in the last part. So I actually didn't ruin this challenge, thank goodness. We are still gonna do it after graduation just because I didn't want her, like, risking actually, like, having to go to work today and then, like, missing her first day of work, because we all know that she would defo miss her graduation to do so. But when it comes to the toddlers, who was it? Where is actually even the notification? There we go. Little Sylvester. That was just so unnecessary, sir. Why are you being so aggressive with it, Almy? He's like, I want these little eco-warriors to start fighting for the environment, and I'm going to show them how. Where is Sylvester? He's currently over here chatting away to Trey. He has the loves water quirk, which I think is hilarious, considering I already have decided that this generation is going to be, like, the eco-warrior of Sulani, and honestly, kind of believes that our family is fucking up the environment on Sulani, which makes sense. I mean, have you seen the size of our house? Like, we are not the good guys in this situation. Oh my goodness gracious me. No, I don't think it's a good idea. Honestly, how do I turn on aging purely just for the gods? Because they need to go. They need to retire. They need to be sent off to a farm or something. They just need to go run free. It's okay. You can let go. You've carried the Sims franchise on your shoulder for 20 odd years now. Be free, my girl. I do need to do it because it's getting super unrealistic. But yeah, being obsessed with water, I mean, great for a child who lives in Sulani. Yes, I just, like, bit my own finger, which was very, very weird. We are gonna decline that job offer, but I'm actually gonna go have him. I'm just gonna teleport him. I'm not gonna have him toddle all the way over here. That would take an arm and a leg. I was meant to say an age. Go play in the open water, because that seems like a really, really smart thing to do without parental supervision. Aiden, I don't want to say I'm judging your parenting styles, but I do think we need to do something about that. Graduation ceremony starts soon. Is it going to give me a pop-up of, like, where to go? As you can all tell from the last video, I don't remember Discover University. It's been a really, really long time since I played it. I do, however, want to get her to enter the lottery. Not that we need it, but I do kind of want to just see. I've never won the Sims 4 lottery, ever, in my life. I have played so many saves. Maybe it's because, like, with the length of the saves, if anything, I feel like this save in particular is, like, the save to do it. Because I feel like when you're playing on, like, a save that you haven't played for that long, like, it, like, lessens your chances. Because it's like, we want to, like, you know, RNG. We want to definitely, like, mix it up. We don't want the same Sims to be winning all the time. So for the first, like, five goes, we're not going to give it to your household. Which, to be fair, I have missed so many lotteries. I feel like I have not done a lot of them. Graduation ceremony is about to happen. Would you like to attend the ceremony? Yes, absolutely. I would like to attend that ceremony. Can we bring the boys with us? I mean, imagine. To be fair, I have got them all dressed up. I kind of want to show you their outfits. They have, annoyingly, I don't personally like this. I always give the disclaimer of when I say something isn't for me, I don't mean to shit on anyone who it is for. Like, I don't mean to tear anyone down. It's just personally not for me, and that is okay. Cletus, my dude. I don't mind, like, complimentary outfits, but, like, matching outfits and, like, family matching outfits defo just, like, aren't for me. But of course they are for Aiden. So that's how I dressed the boys. And it's actually, oh my god, we don't like Haruto. I think that's because he was actually part of the debate club. I actually think he was one of the ones to deny us. We are not gonna try and cheer him up. No way. We are going to, we're gonna mock his outfit, even though we are wearing the exact same outfit as him. Love how she's freaking out here graduating, and yet she's still just bullying people. Aiden, never change, girly. I feel like we should take like a proper like graduation photo, but no one's here. And I kind of don't want to bring Helmy here like just to take photos of her. Why do they have like Foxbury banners up? What the heck? We are Brychester.
Brychester Pride.
Go attend that graduation. But yeah, how cute would it be if we got like, maybe I will. Why is he here? What the hell? Lobster the Larry? Yeah, that's his name. I want to spray him with stink spray. Get lost. You're not even on... I'm so confused. Like, we're literally in Brychester. Like, we're at our university. I don't understand why Larry is here. Is this just, like, weirdly glitched that it's, like, programmed to be Foxbury? I did not go through the hell of Brychester University on a short lifespan for the game to fully just, like, mess up my graduation and give me this sleep paralysis demon. So, I do quite like how it looks like legit, like a costume. Like, it looks like an Among Us character in the sense that, like, you can definitely tell this is where they see through it. I don't like how you can see, like, the flesh underneath, though. I know it's not, like, actually, like, Sims flesh, but I don't trust him. Oh, he's heartbroken because he's stinky. Then you shouldn't have turned up and tried to freaking wind up all of our Sims. That was on you. You know what? You knew what you were doing. Don't give me that. I'm feeling like having lobster Thermidor for dinner tonight. Woo! I hate how the freaking hats despawn before they get like close to your sim. How are you meant to get a good graduation photo? Like, I don't understand. I really, really don't understand it. Like, I know I'm still probably gonna use Larry the Lobster as like my thumbnail, but it's actually very annoying that the game is designed to be like that.
Why does her mouth look like that?
They really didn't think of like screenshot takers and like storytellers when they made that animation. Sims 3 was so much better when it came to the graduation animations. Right, and of course, now we are going to go into our business. We are going to find a job. This is so exciting. Oh my goodness gracious me. Get me in that private attorney career. Obviously, last time I just scrolled down to law and then I entered it and I was like, this is not correct. That is not the truth, Ellen. Whereas it's actually listed as private attorney and it has the little university green symbol next to it to show you that you actually do have the necessary degree for this. Having a relevant university degree means this position will come with higher pay, easier promotions, which is great because she's also entrepreneurial. So hopefully that means we get the last few promotions like super, super easily. More vacation days and a signing bonus. Only one signing bonus can be awarded per every 7 days. Okay. Regardless of career, handling legal cases, practicing law in court, and recruiting high profile clients. It's all the name of the game. It's the name of the game. Yes, go on, Abba. When you're a private attorney, work hard, win your cases, and you might make partner. Why does it just remind me of the Judge Judy introduction? Boom! Aspiration achieved. We got a 2,860 signing bonus. The life of an academic. I honestly just want to unpause it and see where she's going. Oh, should Aiden get a jump start and, yeah, accept the assignment for sure. It's not an easy one, but Aiden has made it through the rigorous challenges of excelling in university and attaining that prize degree. Gain increased skill from researching and more money from contributing knowledge on the research research archive machine. Writing and publishing research papers will also provide a higher payout. Heck yeah! And she is the lead litigator at Bagley and Buckley LLP. Starts Thursday at 8 a.m. bright and early, and she's already a level 8 in that career. So she needs to discuss complex case law. Click on another sim in the law career. How do I know who else is in the fucking law career? I feel like you're in the law career. Oh no, it's just click on another sim, not who is in the law career. We are gonna discuss complex law cases with him. He was super into like debate guilds, so I'm assuming that everyone who likes debating is gonna become either lawyer or a politician. She got 1,000 simoleons purely just for doing that. Clearly, they did not agree on that complex case law because he just had a go at us for it. Aw, I kind of just want her to have like a last meal. We are gonna go for a cheeky cheese pizza. We're barely ever gonna come back to Brightchester, let's be real. Like, we're done with university, which, speaking of, we are gonna change back to our family aspiration, and we are gonna go for successful lineage. Read to a child for a total of 2 hours. We can definitely get that done, I think, with the boys today. Hopefully. Fingers crossed. I feel like I wanna give her carefree, because I feel like her job is gonna be very, very stressful. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and give her that extra trait, considering we had an awful lot of just points. She has so many traits. This actually might be the most amount of like traits I've ever had. I can't really remember how many Bryce had. I feel like she also had a lot, but I feel like Aiden, the overachiever that she is, literally an overachiever. I kind of forgot about that. I feel like she has even more. I always forget that she's got the child of the ocean trait. I like to think that that's slightly passed down to the boys. Like, even though she doesn't really like pay attention to it, she was a little water baby. She's moved on from that, but the boys aren't going to. Love how she's just come back in her little outfit. Wait, this means that we can defo just get a camera and actually get some photos of her still in her graduation get up. I do want to give her a cheeky little makeover. One of you lot asked now that she's an adult if we can give her one. I wanted to wait until she had finished university because I feel like she kind of felt like a mature student, even though she wasn't like that much older. But she still wanted to like be in with the younger ones. So I wanted to hold off. And now that she's actually like in her career and stuff, I want to sort of like give her a very like businessy makeover. That's how I imagine she would want like to portray herself. Obviously, I know she's gonna have like her own like work get up and stuff, but I still wanna do a cheeky little like dress makeover on her. Oh, this is actually a really, really sick shot, especially with like the island and the palm trees in the back. Ooh, okay, getting moody with it. She is absolutely gonna have these on all of the walls. I love how most parents would like take photos with their children and stuff. Aiden's like, just get a few of me at first. Where is this little guy? Why is he so angry? Oh, he's tired. We could technically read him to sleep, but I don't know if that counts. Oh, maybe I purchased kids' books and not actually toddler books. Sorry, didn't know that there was a difference. Why are you undermining their intelligence? Ah, yes, the perfect way to read to your child. Can we just appreciate that she is reading to this little one here, apparently. Love how she made him walk all the way over here. Aiden, that was unnecessary. She's like, work on your movement skill. Oh my word, she keeps making this baby literally work for his books. She's awful. He can't even get up the stairs yet, Aiden. I think we should just go read him to sleep, honestly. Reading them to sleep does actually count towards the total. So she got 1 out of 2 hours. Wow. Queen. Why is Brittany Cho talking to a fish in my toddler's room? Just Sims 4 things. Oh, Sylvester, he's really out here trying to just win me over to become the heir. I love how this was the one generation where I was like, I think we're gonna go like random again. I think I'm gonna like roll for who is gonna be the heir. He's like, no, babe, it's me. It's me. Hi, I'm the problem. It's me. He's actually the opposite of a problem. I don't have to root for the anti-hero with him. He already loves the water. He's an early riser. He said, I have all the personality traits of an eco-warrior. You can trust in me. Honestly, he has my vote. Already, even from being a little toddler, he's so freaking cute. I know I haven't really like shown off the twins too much, but yeah, they have like matching fits and everything. Seems to naturally rise with the sun. Early riser toddlers are more likely to wake up when the sun comes up, so as long as they've already gotten enough rest. On my way, this toddler rules the roost. Not so large, but definitely in charge. I forgot that he's fussy. Work for Aiden starts in about an hour. What would you like to do? We're actually gonna work from home. I forgot that these are like a mix of careers, which I'm actually kind of glad about. I feel like a lot of our careers that we've done in this challenge have been like a mixture of like work from home and then also going in. But I just kind of want to remind myself of actually what lawyers do in this game. So research case law on a research archive machine and then visit university law class. Okay, so yeah, it's like I played engineering recently in my Growing Together series, so it's kind of exactly like that. So we are going to do, and then we will in fact go to a little class, but before that I do want to give her cheeky little makeover as well. I'm not going to show the whole makeover. I'm probably just going to do her everyday wears just because I want her looking a little bit more professional and business-like, and then I'll do the rest like off screen because obviously we do live in Sulani. You're gonna see like her hot weather fit a fair amount. Ooh, he's flying up those stairs. Oh my god, look at him crawling. Oh, is he gonna go get the loves water quirk? Has Casper actually got any quirks? He heard me talking. Oh yeah, he got Wanderer, didn't he? He also has hates being carried. Ooh, he didn't get the quirk. Gilvy really said there can only be one quirky toddler in this household, and it's me. He has main character energy. Definitely gets that from Aiden. Honestly, it gets that from the whole lineage. DeAndre also had main character syndrome. I love how he has loves water quirk and literally has the whole sea surrounding him. Like he could go play in fresh, well, not fresh water, salt water. He basically has his own like public swimming pool at any given opportunity. And yet he's like, no, I'm gonna play in the toilets. Mark Eggleston, not the trust fund baby. He didn't need to win the lottery. I say as I'm sat here with 71,000 simoleons in my bank account and definitely a trust fund baby. We literally didn't even have to take out a student loan. She took out a 10 simoleon loan just for the hell of it. And she's probably never even gonna pay it back just out of spite. She has researched that case law, another cheeky like 1,700 simoleons, and let's actually go plan our outfits. Sorry, little one. I know that you are trying to talk to me. Mummy doesn't listen to fussy little toddlers. I'm sorry to tell you. That's from your father. I'm gonna blame Malcolm for that one. I think I want to go for a little something like this. I mean, I do have these as well, which are very like boss babe, like step on me. And then this with like a little pencil skirt. I don't really know if I'm feeling that actually. I thought that brown was gonna be her color. Let me see if we have this in that like maroon. Oh, really? Honestly, maybe we do this instead. I'm kind of obsessed with this blue. Oh my god, you look so good, Aiden. And then if we just change the hair up. Hello? Oh my word. Mummy, Sorry, mummy. I also think we need to draw it all together with some earrings. I know it's kind of like messing with her eyelashes, but I kind of like her having her seconds done as well. Just like a little bit of Aiden edge, I feel. And then I kind of want to go for like, you know, a more like laid back mum look. Not something that she always like just has to wear in the office. She was such like a wearer of pink, but now I just feel like she's that little bit older. It doesn't really suit her like quite as much. I really like blue on her, actually. This just looks a little bit warm for Sulani in the summer is the only thing that I'm kind of struggling with. I sort of love this. This is still a little bit more like Aiden as a teenager, but just like slightly older, I feel, because she does have that like pink element thrown in. I'm happy with that look. So there we go. The fact that I'm gonna have to just like sit here and see her walking around like that. But I think I am pretty much gonna wrap this part up here. Thank you all so, so much for tuning in. Thank you to all of you who pointed out my mistake in the last part. I very much appreciate it. As you all know, I haven't played university in a while, so I appreciate those of you who have correcting me on that one, because I definitely would have just made the exact same mistake in this part if you hadn't, and then I would have been like, my game is broken. But thankfully, it is not. We are obviously already a level 8 in our career, and she's already looking like she's gonna get a promotion pretty easily, so I feel like this is gonna be a piece of cake. The only thing that I feel we're gonna struggle with the rest of her lifespan is actually this aspiration, because as you all pointed out, she needs to have a child or a grandchild reach the top of their career, which I don't know if she's gonna live long enough for that. I'm kind of hoping that she will, but we will just have to wait and see. Thank you all so much for tuning in, and I will speak to you all in my next one. Bye now.